This is ASMR video tutorials with Ty Roderick. So my beautiful girlfriend got me this AFKA synchro box, which I believe was made in Germany in 1942 to 56, I believe. I don't know a lot about this camera yet, but I know that his medium format film camera run on 120 film, 120 millimeter, sorry. Everything on this camera, because they obviously didn't have any machine parts, is all manual. The aperture ring is here. You wind the film here. And you look in one side for portrait mode, and the other lens for landscape. Everything seems to be very blurry. Maybe I should clean the lenses a little bit. This is obviously a very old camera, so it's very dirty, but I plan on repairing slash restoring it and trying to get some old-timey looking photos of it. Now, I guess we'll go on to a camera that I know quite a bit more about. This is the 5DSR. It is a 49 or 50 megapixel digital SLR. It is very detailed and sharp imaging. There's a 24 to 70 millimeter 2.8 aperture lens on it. Aperture, in my opinion, is basically like the squinting of a lens. Like, a higher aperture would be if you were squinting something into focus. It closes the lens in, so the less light comes through it. A lower aperture photo would have a more interesting depth of field and a softer focus, because the eye would be completely open. Then the ISO of the camera, which you would also set in the use the settings of the camera to increase the light sensitivity. So once you get the depth of field and the focus you want from the aperture, then you adjust the ISO if the picture is still too light or too dark. Shutter speed is also all set digitally on this camera. Is to stop motion. Say you have a model that's moving, or an animal that's running, or say you're shooting sports photography. so on and so forth, you would set a higher shutter speed to stop motion. Whereas if I was shooting stars or a waterfall, I might leave the shutter speed lower in order to catch the movement, so the stream would appear to flow or the stars would appear to move in the sky. Now, I just got this camera, and I haven't shot a lot with it, but I'm very excited to use it. It's a little bit older than this camera, but more detailed. This camera, the 5D Mark IV, is supposed to be better for a combination photographer / cinematographer, because it also has very good autofocus, it has 4K video capabilities, and it's better in low light. This camera definitely more for a professional photographer. This camera could be used for videography or photography. It's all touch screen, it's all, there's GPS, there's Wi-Fi, there's multiple options that make it more tech savvy, I guess. Now, I suppose we'll clean and touch these beautiful cameras. Now the lenses definitely need a more fine brush. This camera is excessively beautiful. Glad you're taking an interest in photography. It's one of my favorite things. different parts of a lens. This lens is one of my favorite lenses. It goes down to a 1.2 aperture, which makes it so I could take a picture of myself, say, with my nose in focus, but the rest of my face out of focus. That's how slightly you can adjust the depth of field. Want to remove any fingerprints or smudges from the lens, because they could show up in the picture, and you don't want a beautiful shot with a fingerprint across the across the vista or across the model's face. So you usually clean your camera before any photo shoot, definitely after if you're in inclement weather or dust, wind, whatever you might happen to encounter. Well, I think that about does it. This was Camera Tutorials and Cleaning with Ty Roderick, and I hope you enjoy yourself. Thank you.